Hello and welcome to this video. In this video, we shall discuss about the advanced metrology. So, regarding the advanced metrology, so we have seen the about CMM, its different structures. So, in this video, we shall see about the points regarding to the CMM. That is, we shall see different probing systems, probing types. So afterwards, so what are the different hardwares and softwares involved, and so what is the different steps involved in operating the CMM. So these things, so we shall see in this video. First one is probing system types. So here you can see, so probing system is one of the important part of the CMM. So it is whole, its cost is very high, means it almost it accounts for 60 to 70% of cost of CMM. So you just imagine, so how much it is important, because it totally accuracy and everything measurements are totally depends on the probing system. So actually it comes in contact with the workpiece, and then it will sense the whatever the dimensions, and then it will convert it into different signals, electronic signals. So there are different probing systems. So there are different types of probing systems. First one is inductive probing, inductive transmission probe. So next one is optical transmission probe. Afterwards, third one is motorized probe, and fourth one is multiple stylus probe. So these are the different types of probing systems. So we shall discuss in detail one by one. First one is inductive transmission probe. So this is the inductive transmission probe. So here you can see, so this is totally a interface. So this is circuit diagrams, so electronic circuit diagrams. So this is the machining center arrangement. So this is the machining center arrangement. So this is the inductive transmission. Afterwards, so this is the inspection probe, means so this will come in contact with the, so afterwards you can see, so this is the tool setting probe. So this is the hardware transmission, so this is the wire transmission system. So this is the transmission probe, this is the tool setting probe, and this is the inspection probe, and this is the inductive transmission. So here, so this probes, so this probes will be very very important in this inductive transmission probe. So these are all, this is a machine control system, means it is an electronic part, so which will play important role for transmitting the whatever the displacement signals into electronic signals. So this is the inspection probe, you can see. So this is the inductive transmission. So this probe will come in contact with the workpiece. So and whenever that come in contact with workpiece, so that will be sensed. Means suppose if you want to measure the dimension from one point to the another point, so first x y z points will be taken here, and then next is XYZ points will be taken here. Means by looking at different XYZ at this point and at this point, both points, so we can measure the dimensions from one point to the between two points. So it CMMs totally works on coordinates, that is X, Y and Z. At one point, whenever you place the probe, so at that point XYZ will be noted, and next when you place at another point, so at that point also x, y and z will be noted, and then so difference, whatever it is difference, so that will give the dimension. So next is optical transmission probe. So here you can see, so this uses light sources, light as a to what you can say, to measure the dimensions to for the inspection. So this is very important. So this is totally become contactless. So this is the transmission probe. So here whenever you want, if you want to measure the dimension at this point, so here you can see, so this is the what you can say focused, this is the workpiece. So this is the what you can say this example is given here. So this is the workpiece and this is the transmission probe. So here what technology used is, so here the light sources, different light sources are used and that will be magnified and measurements will be done. So this is the different operating of this radial adjustment means rotational adjustment. This is translating spindle means, so these are the different adjustments of the probe. So this is totally involved measurements by using the light sources. So next is motorized probe. Suppose, so you can see, so why it is called motorized probe? So here you will find the motor in the head. So there is a motor in the head, so that's why it is called the motorized probe. And this is the extension bar. So this whatever it is, so this is the extension bar. This is the extension bar and this is the stylus. Stylus means it is just like a pointer, so which will come in contact with the workpiece, means object of which we want to measure the dimensions. So why, what is the main advantage is, so it can make the movement throughout 360 degrees. So that is the one of the main advantage of this motorized probe. And it can take the lot of what you can say dimensions. So especially it will be useful for, so where the this type of objects means, so this type of object means it is a thin objects where you need a lot of movement of the probe, that is stylus. So at that time this probe is important. So next is multiple stylus probe. So here you can see there are different stylus probes. So this is a ruby ball stylus. So afterwards this is a disc stylus. So there are different stylus means multiple. So what is the advantage of this is, so in some cases, suppose let us say if you are having the only ball type stylus, so in some cases if we need the disc type stylus for measurements, stylus means it is a pointer which will come in contact with the workpiece. So suppose if there is a ball stylus, agar ab hamare ko disc stylus chahiye to usko kya karna padega, isko replace karke isko fit karna padega. So means it is just like a it will be time consuming, and so means it will be time consuming and means waste of the time. Suppose if you are having the this type of stylus, multiple stylus probes, means if you are having the different styluses in same head, probe head, so then whichever the stylus type we required, so we just need to set that and we can take the readings. So this is the advantage, which it will save the time, but it will be very costlier, because so this many number of stylus means, so it will be costlier. So next is machine control and computer hardware. So this is a machine, so CMM totally how it operates. So it will its stylus will come in contact with the workpiece, and that sense will be converted into electrical signals, electronic signals. So this is done by using the, that is, microprocessors. So microprocessor controlled. So control unit is a microprocessor controlled. So usually a joystick is provided to activate the drive. So this is a totally microprocessor controlled. So next is software for three-dimensional analysis. So you can see, so this is software for three-dimensional analysis, geometry analysis. So means, so whenever we measure the dimensions of the different work pieces, so they are three-dimensional. So agar uska geometry usko analysis karne gaye to software bhi waisa hi chahiye. So that software will be included in the CMM. So what actually we are going to do in the CMM? So you can see, first is measurement of diameter, okay, center distances, lengths, geometrical and form errors in prismatic components, etc. There are many dimension measurements we can do by using the CMM. Measurement of diameter, center distances, lengths, geometrical and form errors in prismatic components. Next is online statistics for statistical information in batch. So statistical information, so this concept will be studied in the quality control. So we are going to study in detail what is meaning of statistical quality control. So in that time, so you can understand more clearly. So next is, so parameter programming to minimize the CNC programming of similar parts. So parameter programming means ये छोटा छोटा प्रोग्राम्स होता है पर्टिकुलर पार्ट के लिए, उसको सेव किया जाता है. तो नेक्स्ट टाइम उसी प्रोग्राम चाहिए तो उसको डायरेक्टली पिक करके मेन प्रोग्राम में उसको पेस्ट कर सकते हैं, मतलब उतना टाइम बच जाता है. तो दिस इज डन बाय द डन इन द सीएमएम. आफ्टरवर्ड्स मेजरमेंट ऑफ प्लेन एंड स्पेशल कर्व्स. सो दिस एनालिसिस कैन बी डन बाय यूजिंग द सीएमएम. नेक्स्ट इज डेटा कम्युनिकेशंस, so we can also do this. Next is digital input and output commands for process integration. So this is also digital input and output commands for process integrations. Afterwards, interface to CAD softwares. So it will directly give the interface to CAD softwares, means CAD software ko directly usko use kar sakte hai, isme interface ho jata hai. So next is programming or measurement with CMM. So what are the different steps, means how CMM is used, means how CMM is used for measurements, what are the different steps involved in measurement using the CMM. First one is, step one is home the CMM. होम द सी एम एम मीन्स उसको ओरिजिन सेट करने का. तो उसका जो भी स्टाइलस रहता है तो उसको पहले ओरिजिन सेट करने का, दैट इज कॉल्ड द होम द सी एम एम. नेक्स्ट इज क्वालिफाई द टिप. क्वालिफाई द टिप मीन्स जो टिप रहता है, स्टाइलस रहता है, तो उसको प्रॉपरली इंस्पेक्शन करने का, वो प्रॉपरली वर्क कर रहे कि नहीं, सो वेदर इट इज वर्किंग आर नॉट. सो वी नीड टू चेक इट प्रॉपरली, दैट मीन्स इट इज क्वालिफाइड, मीन्स इट इज चेकड. नेक्स्ट इज अलाइन द पार्ट, मीन्स जो भी पार्ट को इंस्पेक्शन करने का है तो उसको प्रॉपरली प्लेस करने का, प्रॉपरली अलाइन करने का. नेक्स्ट इज मेजर द पार्ट. सो नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज, सो वी कैन टेक द डिफरेंट डायमेंशंस ऑफ द पार्ट, मीन्स सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट स्टेप्स इन्वॉल्व इन द व्हाट यू कैन से सीएमएम. नेक्स्ट इज लास्ट वन इज, दिस इज अ रिप्रेजेंटेशन. सो रिप्रेजेंटेशन मीन्स इट इज अ what you can say, this is a whatever the data we are going to measure, so that will be converting into particular format, particular representation, so in whichever the format we required. So these are the different steps followed in the measurement by using the CMM. So thank you for watching this video.